A Day in the Life of Sundar Pichai, Google CEO. With over 130,000 employees and a market cap of $2 trillion, Google is one of the world's foremost tech companies. The not-so-easy job of managing this many resources and humans is hinged on the shoulders of none other than Sundar Pichai, the Indian-American Chief Executive Officer of Google and his parent company, Alphabet Inc. In this video, we'll be taking a look at the daily rituals that fuel Pichai's productivity and help him call the shots at one of the biggest companies in the world. We'll also discuss his hot takes on trendy topics such as cryptocurrency and metaverse. Born in Chennai, India on the 10th of June 1992, Sundar Pichai's early life was relatively modest without access to computers and basic amenities. Still, he rose above the challenges to earn a degree in metallurgical engineering at the Indian Institute of Technology, Kharagpur. His impressive performance earned him a scholarship to Stanford University, where he completed his master's degree and PhD in materials science and engineering. Sundar is famous for his endearing personality within and beyond the four walls of Silicon Valley. Sundar Pichai emerged as CEO of Google at 34 years, taking over from Eric Schmidt in August 2015. This achievement made him one of the youngest CEOs of a Fortune 500 company. In 2019, Pichai was named CEO of Google's parent company, Alphabet Inc. He has a 96% approval rating on Glassdoor, and the New York Journal once referred to him as a really nice guy. Everyone seems to agree that Sundar is a perfect gentleman, but how does he kickstart his day? Although he admits that he is not a morning person, Sundar Pichai leaves the bed between 6:30 and 7:30 a.m. Despite leading affairs at a futuristic company like Google that helps people move their businesses online, Pichai has some old-school habits meshed into his morning routine. His first dose of the daily business news is usually drawn from a physical copy of the Wall Street Journal newspaper while performing the very English ritual of drinking a cup of tea. Fair enough, he also spares some time to read the New York Times online. I'm not a morning person, so I need my time with my paper and tea to wake up and kind of get going. Pichai told tech news platform Recode the next task in his morning routine is breakfast, which is most likely to be an omelette. As soon as breakfast is sorted, Pichai reaches for his wardrobe to select a casual outfit for work, and off he goes. For someone in a highly ranked position as Pichai, you'd imagine that meetings make up a large part of his daily schedule. However, he handles things a little bit differently than most other chief executives in Silicon Valley. Sundar Pichai is flexible when it comes to meetings. Reports say he loves to pace around during sessions, and sometimes he takes them spontaneously while walking. When discussions in a forum hit a deadlock, Pichai excuses himself for a while and most likely returns with a solution. "I love to pace and actually think that I have to start walking," he said. Pichai has also made it a habit to listen more and talk less during meetings. He opens the floor for all participants to make their arguments, after which he'd express his ideas or opinions about the topic. Leadership style and interaction. Apart from his intellectual qualities and problem-solving orientation, Sundar Pichai's leadership style and mode of interaction are some of his most significant selling points. This has earned him the respect of his colleagues and subordinates and aided his meteoric rise to become CEO of Google. Martin Hooft, a former Google employee who turned partner, eulogizes Pichai's interpersonal relationship skills while comparing him to founders Larry Page and Sergey Brin. "Larry can take on that blue sky vision. He's not afraid of setting an audacious goal, whereas I think Sundar is more of a great operator. While Larry and Sergey Brin have these visions that can start these initiatives, I think Sundar, that's the guy that can just get it done. He can assemble the team, he can appoint the right people, and he's the one that makes it happen," Hoof told Business Insider in 2014, 1 year before Pichai emerged as CEO. Pichai goes to the office about two or three times weekly due to the restrictions caused by the pandemic situation. However, he regularly communicates with Google founders Larry and Sergey, depending on his needs. Projects. Since he arrived at Google in 2004, Pichai has been responsible for developing and managing a couple of projects for the tech giant, including Google Chrome, Chrome OS, Google Drive, Gmail and Google Maps, Chromebook and Android. Currently, Pichai and his team are working on Project Starline, an immersive video conferencing tech. Other projects he's working on include optimizing the search bar, Lambda AI, which will allow natural dialogues to be used during conversations between robots and AI, as well as Google's quantum computer. We're building a diverse set of businesses, but underlying all of the investments we're making is AI. We have invested $100 billion in AI in the last 5 years, and so applying AI in a deep way is probably where we will create the biggest opportunity, Sundai told Bloomberg's Emily Chang. Office space. To reduce distractions, Pichai's workspace is designed in a simple and organized manner to help reduce congestion and maintain a longer attention span. Right before we jump into the last section, if you've made it this far, make sure to like and subscribe for more content like this. During an interview with Bloomberg Technology, Sundai Pichai was put through his paces by anchor Emily Chang, who asked some quick-fire questions. Apparently, Google's CEO is learning a new skill, and it's not artificial intelligence, computing, or any of that sort. The Stanford graduate is spending his free time learning how to make pizza. He's probably doing it with the help of some AI software or machine. Yeah. When he's not making pizza, you can find him listening to podcasts or watching music videos on YouTube with his children. While cricket is India's number one sport, Pichai couldn't decide which one he loves the most between cricket and soccer football. Instead, he opted for both, saying, "It's tough. I'll pick both. Please don't make me choose." Pichai also admits to watching the popular comedy drama series Ted Lasso, as well as the South Korean Netflix film Squid Game. Although he cheekily admits that he prefers Ted Lasso because it's much more calm. Metaverse or real world? The Google CEO believes both can coexist without problems. If done correctly, you shouldn't feel the need to make a choice, he said, adding that the presence and realness of the real world will end up mattering for a long time. Does Pichai have a vested interest in crypto? Currently, Sundai Pichai doesn't hold any cryptocurrency. However, he admits that he once dabbled into it, but he's in and out for now. Message to his younger self. Like the rest of us, Sundai Pichai does have a lesson he wished he'd learnt when he was in his 20s. He's human after all. His message to his younger self is a 7-letter word called patient. I think when you're young, you're very impatient, which is a great thing, but sometimes you do amazing things by slowing down and being focused and doing it over a period of time. Evening routine. Sundai heads home to his wife, Angelia Pichard, his two kids, their pet Jeffrey, at the close of work. Although he's a workaholic, the Indian native executive doesn't go home with unfinished work from the office. He also doesn't test Google prototypes in his house yet. However, he speculates that he could be trying them soon. Evenings are also when Sundai works out to burn calories and stay fit. He enjoys having conversations with his children. Hence, he tries to do it daily before heading to bed as much as possible. Daily routines are vital for sustaining a person's energy level. It is essential to have a good routine in order to feel motivated and productive in the long term. Using Sundai Pichai as a case study, we've been able to establish that a good daily routine will improve your level of productivity and general well-being. This is the secret behind many successful entrepreneurs who manage enormous resources and employees. By incorporating good habits such as exercise, adequate sleep, reading, etc. into your daily routine, you will notice a number of positive changes, including reduced stress hormones, improved mood, increased energy, and a higher life expectancy rate. Does your daily routine include any elements from Sundai's daily ritual? Will you be looking to adopt some of his habits? Let us know in the comments section. Also, be sure to check out our next video about internet cables and how they travel through the oceans.